Okay, so we're ready for the second shir on Yemash Min Yatzeres. Yesterday we dealt with how the Kalim Batzilus are Bechinas Yesh, and we gave was a bit noisy. We gave a geshmak, very geshmak view of the Sheirish HaKelim in the Isya Shabbat. But the objective of the Maimon going forward is not to explain about the Kalim, it's to explain about the O. So, like we started with Loizu Wubacha Kalim Bechinas Yesh, and then the paragraph at the bottom of Nuntes tells us, Bechinas The whole point is about the Eir of the Esefriz Atzilus, the Eir HaKav, how it is in relation to the Eir Nesef Shifnei Atzimtzum. That is also Vuchinas Yesh. So we can explain how the Eir of Atzilus, the Eir of Esefriz, is Vuchinas Yesh. And this is going to be a Aritus Habir and an involved beer. And truth be told, we could spend the rest of our lives on these few pages. We could spend the rest of our lives on. You ready? No? Let's give it a go.
Give it a shake.
We're trying not to laugh. Well, just sit still. As I say, we could manage to spend, because we could spend forever on this, we're going to actually do it very quickly.
Right. I get what you're saying. Okay.
Because whatever we're going to say is not going to be enough.
We'll always be users.
No, it's a very, very well, what we're going to get from this is a very well explained construction of something, but I would there is not a heavy amount of biur, and it's about concepts that we should already have a familiarity with. Now, the extent to which you do have a familiarity with it, it's questionable. Some yes, some no. You'll see there's in some sections, footnote 621 is very substantial to give you the sugya of what we're discussing over here. As I say, we're trying to give a guided tour through the Hemshech. And if we get stuck over here, really exploring the ideas that are being discussed, which are some of the most fundamental ideas of the Haskalah of Chassidus, we're not going to get very far, and I think that in the context we're going to read it somewhat superficially, and because it's like a whole shtickle, well, the idea is to get as much of it in a short amount as possible, so then we can talk about it. But if we're going to stumble over every line, I think it's going to not actually be the Toyalis. You've got to remember the beginning of this. What are we trying to achieve? We're trying to achieve an explanation that even the Eir after the Tzimtzum is B'chinas Yesh.
Let's go
And so we're going to Lefi Erech, the Eir Shlifnei HaTzimtzum. So primarily we're talking about, at least at this stage, the Erech Sefiris, which we broadly call Eir HaKav, how it is in relation to the Eir Nesef Shlifnei HaTzimtzum. So the Bechinas Yesh. And that, why are we saying that? Because that takes us back to our Pasuk, that in order for there to be Hisavas HaElam, there has to be a Tzimtzum in the Eir. The Eir also has to be in the Samsim, and the Eir has to come to be with Bechinas Yesh. That enables the Osius and the Kalim to become prominent. And once the Osius and the Kalim become prominent, they're able to be Ma'alim and Masrim and the Eir and create Olam HaSbiyah. So that is our objective. So to keep that objective in mind of what we're trying to achieve, and hopefully it will be Batzlacha. Okay, so starting again from the beginning of the paragraph and the test. When it comes to the Eid of Esther, and even the Maila Me'atzilus, all the way up to Ak, which is the Reishis Hishtalshtos after the Tzimtzum Rishon, that in Bechinas Eid Hakava Nimshach La'achra Tzimtzum, Shekam Hu Bechinas Yesh, not just the Kelim, Levad Me'a Kelim, also the Eid, Vizhavusui Hu Alidei HaTzimtzum. And the emergence of the Eid Hakav Bechinas Yesh is because of the Tzimtzum. Liyos me'ayin liyesh. Such that it merges the relationship between the Eir Nosef Shifnei HaTzimtzum and the Eir HaKav. It's al derech an inyin of Eir Ayin liyesh. Okay. Dehine Eir HaKav. Ima yoyis shu batul v'dovek m'makeirei. Even though the Eir HaKav is an Eir. And therefore it's batul and dovek m'makeirei. That's what makes it into an Eir. How can you introduce this whole notion of yeshus in Eir? Yeshus and Hafroda, Yeshus is together, Hafroda of some sort. Separateness and detachment, distinctiveness, otherness. That's what Yeshus is. Eir, by definition, is something which is bottle and dovuk. So even though it's bottle and dovuk, that's what we mean when we say Iyuvachayuichad. This mamish ba'achtus, the Eir of Atzilus.
With the Kelim.
No. With Ihu, with the Eibishter. Shu b'chinas chad mamash b'chinas yichud atzmi.
And Ihu v'gamay echad.
The Kelim are also b'achdus.
With Ihu.
That's a whole chiddush. Even though the b'chinas yesh, they're still elikus. What does it mean, echad? They're elikus in the manner that they're able to create yesh mi'ayin. Whole simon chav. Yeah? But the chiddush, so the fact that Ihu v'chayu echad is nishkin chiddush. Moving is oy, you should be beachtus. Ein shein ze kumay oy dova hamadabik misyachid. The nature of the achtus of the oy of Atzilus and the oy rakav bichlal is not like two things that become attached, two separate things. Kiim kumay dova echad mamish. But rather, when we talk about the achtus of the oy, it's like two things. It's not like two things. It's rather like one thing. The achtus is so absolute. And this is the distinctiveness and the superiority that the Eirus of Atzilus have in their Achdus over the Kelim. Because it doesn't say Ihu v'chayuhi v'gamui chad. It says Ihu v'chayuhi chad, Ihu v'gamui chad. It's two different chad. The Achdus is a different type of Achdus. The Achdus of the Kelim, the Yichad the Ihu v'gamui, Hayne v'chinas ha-Kelim hukumei oidoba misyachid. It's in the manner of two things being united. But not out two things, because we know that the Kelim and Mamash B'chinas Yesh, even though they're Elikus, Chachma, Chesed, V'chuli. Or K'may Guf and Nefesh, Yuchadim, Zayim, Zayim, Batachlis, comparable to the way the Guf and the Nefesh are Misyachid. You can't differentiate between the Guf and the Nefesh. They're Misyuchad, but they're still distinctly two separate things that are Misyuchad with each other. Because the Kelim are a Metzias Dava, so therefore the Yichud that they have is not a Yichud where it becomes completely blurred to become one thing, but it becomes like two things that are united. But the Yichud that comes from the Eir is a fundamental Yichud. It's not as if the Eir comes as an additional separate thing that becomes attached to the Eir Nosef Shifnei HaTzimtzum or to the Eir Shlamayla Me'atzilus or Kumei Oy Dova HaMisyachid Ela Sheim Dova Echad, rather like one thing. End of Sugrayim. So, and it compares it to the what we discussed above about the Keichat HaNefesh, how they are nafshim. Kmoi yoyir b'chayis ha-nefesh nimshach lahachi yisaguf legabi etzim ha-nefesh she'eini muhus achim himenu chuli kemish nisboilil. So it's comparable to these keichas ha-nefesh. And their relationship with the etzim ha-nefesh. That we don't treat them as two separate entities. Even though it's a ha'ara, mikomokim herim nafshi mamish. Those keiches, even though they are ha'ara and they come mislabish in the goof, they are mischalik into keiches of chach mechesed v'chuli. Nevertheless, we describe them as nafshi. K'makein hu bechinas ha'iris datzilis. The same can be said of the iris datzilis. She'ein bechinas mohus achem ein seif ha'matzil. They don't become a separate entity from the ein seif ha'matzil. They are part and parcel of the Ein Seif HaMatzil, the originator of the Eiris of Atzilus. Umameila ha'yichud behem u'bechines yichud atzmi. So that being the case, the yichud they have with their origin is a yichud atzmi. So this is all saying, notwithstanding the fact that the Eiris of Atzilus are u'bechines yichud atzmi. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Mikol makim ein adim eklal agabim mekerim. Still nevertheless, they're incomparable to their market. In what way? Shari oir hakav, hari hu b'chinas metzias oir v'ziv al kuponim. A defining feature of oir hakav is what? That it's a metzias of oir. It's not anything else. It's not a non-metzias. It's a dover ma. It's poil pu'ula. It's mislabish in kelim. It's a something. Right? It's a metzias oir v'ziv al kuponim, hachis oilem es nivroim. Gemeshu b'mekeire, and when this oir, the oir which is dovek with, its origin, its moke, the way that oir is in its moke, but oir in seish lifnei atzimtzum, shesham ha'oir kolo b'atzmusay, shu b'chinas ayin v'efes mamish, ad she'en oilem b'shem ziv oir klal. So there's a fundamental difference between the oir lifnei atzimtzum and the oir hakav shel acher atzimtzum. The era kafshel achat simson is a metzias dover. At least a mokel la'ilamis. Masha enkin the era nesuch lifnei atzimson.
When we say it was the
is an oir, which is ainu oila b'shem ziv. It's not metzias dover.
Was the simson that the oir was metallic and then there was space for it?
We have a bracket in a second. Ukmoy oir beziv hashemesh keshu beguf kador hashemesh haru botul betachlis ad she'eina oila b'shem ziv klal. So yeah, the oir hashemesh is an oir which is miyuchad and davuk with its mokir, but it's be'ein aroich the oir the way it is chutz lemekire k'moy she'meila aretz in comparison to the oir the way it is beguf kador hashemesh where it's be'ein oila b'shem ziv klal. It's the same thing. It can't be a mokila elamis because itself is not begeder metzias. We're going to be mairich a bit later about in order to create a metzias dover, the thing that creates it has to also be a metzias dover. Not a metzias dover gashmi necessarily, but it has to be a metzias dover. Can't get something from nothing. Much as we talk about Yeshma Ayin, something never comes from nothing. Depends what you mean by nothing. But nothing in the context of this sense. If something is not Eila B'Shem Klal, is Bottle the Gamri, it won't create anything else. So the Eira in Seish Lifnei Atzimtzum, Eina Eila B'Shem Klal, it's quite the Eira which is Kubakuf Kadra Shemesh. Bottle the gamri is bein arich to the eir hakav shel achra timtzum. Chosh, okay, the eir b'chayu ichad, the eir is dovuk, and the eir is not like even a dova, it's shnei dvarim hamis yachatim, it's a yichud atzmi. Nevertheless, it's bein arich. V'haynu means to say. And try and read this right. Besides for the fact that the oir, the way it is, or even in the moshul, the way the oir, the ziv hashemesh is beguf kader hashemesh, hu naila yisa harbe. Besides for this fact that it's naila yisa harbe. Ukumay moshul the oir beziv hashemesh kumayshu beguf kader hashemesh. The intensity of the oir is much more much greater in the Guf Kader Hashem Rishon, the way it is Meir Ba'aretz. Yeah. Shemavu b'sefer shalbeinim the Meir Shom b'vichnas Yesa Se'es Yesa Oz Miha Arosi Achal Kach B'chol Lo Ilam, like explains in Tanya how the way is Meir afterwards in on the earth isn't comparable to the way it is B'Guf Kader Hashem Rishon, where it is a far greater intensity. So this is where your question comes in, Levi. What are we talking about? Is it completely not an oir? If it's a completely bottle, then what is the whole story of Tzimtzum, where we describe it as the oir is Mamala Mokim Acholol, and you had to have a Tzimtzum in the oir in order for there to be the emergence of Eilamis, right? If it's completely bottle, and you know the B'shim Tzimtzum is Tzim Klal, why do you have to be a Tzimtzum? It's not there. Eilam Mitzvah is Klal. So in this bracket, it's going to explain the other point. Because now we're saying, besides for this, the oir is also far greater, far more intense. How can it be not an oir bichlal, ein oir b'shem shiv klal, and at the same time be na'ali yizah harba? So it says, "Ulichayda eich yitzak shneim." How can both of these two things be true? Shemei sham b'yisa, but ein oir b'shem oir chuli. Mavu b'makim acher, the yishleim shizol ke'inyan shraga b'tira. This is comparable to the concept of having a flame in the middle of the day in, during the intensity of the daylight. Just describes how you can have an oir, and it can be a very strong oir, but because of the presence of the etzem, it lacks any tfisas makom, has a bittel. So you, during the daylight, if you have a flame, it can sometimes be completely invisible because of the intensity of the sunshine that overpowers and overwhelms the visibility of the shraga, of the lamp, of the ordinary flame. So the point being is you can have two things at the same time. You can have the presence of oir, and the oir can be headed to tefisas makom. Okay? To answer the question?
Not real to the real head of the market. Not real to the head of the market.
Seeing it's not a bit of bad.
If you still know that that's a light, even though it's insignificant.
Like if you touch that flame, you'd still get burnt.
Right, or you can still, even though it's insignificant,
yeah,
you still see it.
So you have an element of both.
Uh-huh. So there's no difference in the atzmo of the flame when it's in the atzmo and then when after the tzimtzum. Just that because there's a siluk of its.
Okay, this is a bit of the minute. Yeah.
A bit.
Look up 609. For some peculiar reason, in my footnote 609, I just put on the side Re'etav Rishayim Ches. But I didn't put a page number or reference to what mine is. I've got no idea what I was thinking about. But there's somewhere in Ayin Ches, if I look through the whole Ayin Ches, you might find what I was. What I meant there.
And it wasn't a mistake saying Nun Ches.
No. The Pasuk is from Nun Ches. I don't know what I meant by Tofrish Ayin Ches. I'm still trying to figure that out. Okay, so you have a good question though. My point is that you have a good question, and we haven't got time now to fully indulge it. Just like we talked about the Eir of Ziv HaShemesh, the same can be said about the Eir, the way it is Lifnei HaTzimtzum, which is far greater and more intense than the Gilu HaKav. So the Kav, even though it originates in the Eir of Ziv HaTzimtzum, nevertheless, it's still a kav, a line, which is narrow, which is limited. And that's the impact of the tzimtzum on that oir. Atru be'erach ha'ilamis, to the point where it can be be'erach ha'ilamis, can be the shedush u'makir ha'ilamis. Asha en kin ha'oir k'mesh lifnei ha'tzimtzum, eina be'erach ha'ilamis klal mitzad ma'alasei. So we said, not just that, levad zois. Ulavad zois, besides for this element, of the relationship between the Eir and Seif Shlifnei HaTzimtzum, the Eir and Seif Shla Achra HaTzimtzum, that the Eir and Seif Shlifnei HaTzimtzum is B'mayla Harbi Yaisa. It's also Eini Beged, the Mokila Eilam is Mitzad HaBitl. In addition to its intensity, it's also not a plausible origin of the world. Why? Because of its bittul. Because the Eilam Sishnei HaTzimtzum B'chnas Dveikus M'mekeiru Botul M'yuchud M'mekeiru Kol Kach Ad She'inu Eilu B'shem Klal Yis Beged Mokila Davama. He's got such a bittul and yichud with Atman Sein Seif, it's not constituted to be a mocker for anything else.
Does it have no definition?
It's self-effacing, as we sometimes say.
Does it have no definition when it's in its sherish?
Definitely vis-a-vis the
obviously it's a greater light than the cab. The cab is just one what a defined piece of light, and this is dovek and something, so it's like the whole shemesh. Because it's then like the whole shemesh. Right.
Yep. So Masha Enkin, Rakav, Hari Bukhinas Matsias Eir Vaziv, Alkopanim, Lis Mokel Eidem as an Ivroim. Imkain, Hari Hu, Bukhinas Matsias Yesh Alkopanim. So this is what we're trying to articulate and emphasize, this last line of the paragraph. Hari Hu, Bukhinas Yesh Alkopanim. Not just the Kalim of Bukhinas Yesh. Loizu, Bubacha Kalim in Bukhinas Yesh. Kamoi Kain, Esavis Batsilus, Lamailam is a Rakav, he's also Bukhinas Yesh.
Maybe
the Neshama Yesh as well. Hmm? Some of the Neshama Yesh
as well. We've already said the Neshama is a Yesh. We said it
becomes a Nivro. It's a Nivro. Defined Nivro.
Definitely defined.
If it's created from the Kalim of Atzilus, there's a Shtickle from the Kalim of Atzilus, and the Kalim of Atzilus are a Yesh. For sure, there's a Bein Arich of the Yesh of Atzilus, the Gab of the Yesh of Biyah.
Is it a Nivro?
Hmm?
It's a mohos of Atzilus, no?
It's a Nivro.
So the Melach is a Nivro.
Did you not? Yesterday we did this. Who asked me if that's the beginning of Mitzvah's Neshama? Neshama is a Nivro.
And it's from the mohos of Atzilus.
Yeah. Right. For sure it's a Nivro. Okay. So we've sort of introduced the point. Introduce the point that the Yesh, the Eir and Seif Achra HaTzimtzum, is also b'chinas, to a certain degree, relatively speaking, b'chinas Yesh and a Dovah Ma. In contrast to the Eir and Seif Achra HaTzimtzum, we're now going to elaborate on that, okay? And I give it a much more defined structure in the concept of Yesh, Ayin, Ayin, Yesh. That's the sugya we're going to be dealing with now. Okay, let's go. Ubir Reinyin Hu. I told you we're going to be going fast. Dinixiv, Keldeus Havaya. So, it says in Isaiah. Sorry, in Shmuel. It says in Shmuel, Keldeus Havaya. That's in Avaya, there are deus plural. Shish beis deus. So in Kabbalah, explains that this is yichudi lo yichud dato, das elyon, das tachtin. Yeah? Now, so we're going to explain what is das elyon and what's das tachtin. Das elyon, hu shalamay le yesh ulamata ayin. That is the das in elyon. Not. Remember, not from the perspective of the Elyon. Here we're talking about two different locations. In a place called Elyon, this is the Deo. This is the pattern. The pattern is that Lamaila is Yesh and Lamati is Ayin. Behind Yeshu Bechinas Yesh Amiti Dein Seif. The Yesh over here we're talking about is the Yesh Amiti. Atmosphere in Seif. Shenikri Yesh Hashem Amiti Simotse. Why is it called a Yesh? Because it's the only real Matzias. It's not Yesh, like a Yesh Anivra. It's Yesh in the sense that it's the true existence. It exists in a sense independent of anything else. Okay? It's not Kadmei, nothing Nothing preceded it, nothing invented it, nothing sustains it. It's a stable existence. Atma Sainsif. Amitis HaYesh. That's what Yeshus really is. Being. To be, to exist. V'ha'ayin. So what is the... That's the Maima. That's the Yesh. The Ayin is what? U'b'chinas ha'erin seif, shu b'chinas gilu ha'atzim. So the erin seif, shalifnei ha'timtzum, is the Ayin. So that's Elyin. Is a description of Eirin Seif, of the matter of the relationship between Atmos Eirin Seif, or Atmos Ein Seif to make it simpler, and the Eirin Seif, Shlifnei Atimtim. Lamaila Yesh, or Lamata Ayin. We describe the Atmos as Yesh, because it's the Amitis Amitis, and we describe the Eir as Ayin, for the reasons we described above, because it's Dovuk, it's Bottle, Hedet Fitzes Mokim. Yeah? V'nikra ayin mibeis taimi. The reason we call the Eirin Seif Shlifnei HaTzimtzum ayin is for two reasons. Ha'alef, al shem shu ha'or levad, she'ein bo'i min ha'etzim klal, v'mishkosu mokim ache, v'chol ha'or nikra ayin, lefi she'ein rak ha'or levad, she'ein lo metiyas b'tzad atzmi chuli. What is a ha'or? A ha'or is only a reflection of something else. It has no identity of its own. It's merely a reflection of something else. So you call it ayin. It doesn't have its own yeshus. If Yeshus is the Pshat to be an emes ha-metzius, which is independent, self-sustaining, a ha'ara is the opposite of that.
Right.
It's tolu, it depends entirely on its mokeh. So as such, it's called ayin. Ayin, in therefore, is the Pshat here. What is the Pshat ayin? Ayin means not a yesh. There's a yesh and there's not a yesh. That's one reason why the Eirin Seif Shlifnei HaTzimtzum is called Ayin, because it's not a Yesh, it's a Ha'ara, and therefore doesn't have all of the characteristics of a Yesh. V'habeis, the second reason.
Would it be fair to say that a Yesh is not Dovuk? It's not something that's Dovuk or something?
Of course not. It's independent.
It is.
Things are Dovuk with it, but it's right, not Dovuk anything else.
Itself.
V'habeis.
Yesh HaMityanis.
V'habeis, and the second reason we call Eirin Seif Shlifnei HaTzimtzum Ayin. Mitzad habitul, shul bottle legabi mekeda ad she'enil b'shem kal, which is the way we described it above. It's so bottle and so self-effacing that it doesn't have a name. It can't even be defined. Kliyoshu b'chnas gilui ha'etzem she'dovik mekedai negrish by mekedai. It has an awareness of its mokeh. Ha'inu she'ein seif atzmosumus hu amitzei yesh. It's fully aware of what it's being Megala, which is the Atzmus Amos, the Emes HaYesh. Ulevad Dehu Ve'Efes Biladi Klal. What is the Amitis HaYesh? What is the Pshat Yesh as the Ebishter? What is it being Megala? It's what I discussed last year. The Ulevad Dehu Ve'Efes Biladi Klal. There's nothing else besides the Ebishter. He's the only Emes HaMatzius. And that itself induces that awareness of nothing else besides the Ebishter means it also doesn't exist. It creates a bitl in itself. So b'chinas bitl la'ei she'en b'chinas mitzias klal. L'chein ein ha'shayach l'haniach alav shum she'en kim ayin. You can't call it anything. You rather have to call it ayin. So ayin mitzad it not being a yesh is the first reason. And ayin mitzad ha'bitl is why it's called ayin. Okay, two reasons why the Eirin Seif Shlifnei HaTzimtzum is called ayin. That's elyon. Omnam das tachtein hu mi ayin l'yesh. Das tachtein, if you're the seder is ayin, then yesh, not yesh ayin, you're ayin yesh. Da yesh, the ayin is lamayla and the yesh is lamata. Da yesh, ubichinas ayesh anivra. Shnikri yesh ashem shem mugash yeshusay. Here, the yeshus of the yesh anivra is not for the same reason of the yesh amiti. The yeshus over here is a yeshus which comes from what? The being self conscious. It's self-consciousness. Shemugash Yeshusa. It's aware of its existence. V'ha'ayin.
What do you mean by that?
It's self-aware that it exists, that it's a being.
And the Yesh HaMiti is not aware that it exists. Surely.
Of course it's you. First of all, don't want to get into that. But that's not why it's called a Yesh.
Right.
That the term yesh in relation to the yesh amiti is not a statement about its self-awareness. It's a statement about its originality and self-sufficiency.
Right. And the ayin is not a yes because it's self-aware that it's not anything.
Which ayin are you talking about? The ayin, the conversation of the atzim?
Yeah, yeah.
One time. Above us?
Above the Das Tachlin, right? So, yeah.
I need you to get your names right.
Das Elyon.
In Das, the Ayin of Das Elyon.
Yeah.
What it describes over here, the reason why it's called Ayin is because by definition it's Dovuk, which means it's not a Yesh.
Right. It's nothing. It's not.
Because it relies on its Mokeh to exist.
It's not a Yesh of itself. It's only a Yesh when it's when it's in its Mokeh. And then it's just its Mokeh.
So it's not itself. So it's not a yesh.
Right.
So, and the second reason is because of its bittul. But in Das Tachtin, the term yesh means self-awareness.
Right.
For ayin hu mekeiroi hamahava isi. And the term ayin in Das Tachtin doesn't mean what it meant in Das Elyon. Here it means the shedish umakir of the yesh. B'nikra ayin al shem she'enim musuk. Why is it called ayin? Because it's not comprehended. The yesh, who has awareness of its own existence, is incapable of grasping the origin of where it came from. She'anivra masigas atzmi. A created being can grasp its own existence, its own Metzias. But its origin, it's incapable of grasping. And that's why it's called ayin. For two reasons again. He calls this thing that he doesn't understand ayin. Why? Because he can't come up with any better name. Any other name would be a sort of
definition of it.
A defining thing of it. Ayin is just what it's just not. It's not something that I grasp, and therefore I'm going to call it notness, nothingness. We don't know what it is. I can't give it a shame, something that's going to define what it really is, because I know what it is. They called the mon, because they know what it was. So they gave it this sort of just mon, whatever it is, a non-name. The name is a sort of like a void. It's like a non-definitive name. Ayin.
Right.
Vagam, also, pirish ayin, ki'ilu einan. It feels as if, from the perspective of the nivra, not only do I not know what it is, I'm convinced I do have a maki, but I've got no clue, I can't grasp what that is. And it gets to the point where it's as if it's not even there. It seems like my moku is so beyond me, it's as if it's not there. Ki'ilu English. When something is not grasped, there's nothing to grasp onto. Both of them are incorporated into this notion of the ayin being something which is incomprehensible to the nivra. Because it's not comprehended by us, we're not able to give it a name. As if it's not there at all. And that's why it's called ayin. Now, very different reasons for why the Eirin Seishu Lifnei HaTzimtzum is called ayin. Don't forget, here we're not primarily interested in the yeshus of the Yesh HaAmiti of Das Elyon, or the yeshus of the Nivra of Das Tachlin. We're interested in these two things called ayin. So our first important point to stress is how just because they're both called ayin does not make them the same thing. It's not the same ayin. One is the Eirin Seishu Lifnei HaTzimtzum, and one is the Eir HaKav Shel Acher HaTzimtzum. Now, v'oid, furthermore, nikra ayin al shem shu b'chinas lo yidovo. One of the reasons why the ayin of the Yesh HaNivra, the ayin of Das Tachtin, is called ayin, is it's not a dover in a certain sense. In the sense of a nivra being a dover, a thing, an entity. Shanivru b'chinas davar. Tahainu shu b'chinas metzias gashmi. A nivru is a metzias gashmi. We're not just talking about malachim and dargis in ilam abriya and ilam yitzira. We're talking about a nivru gashmi. You and me. Shu b'chinas metzias gashmi. So we're a davar. B'hamokir ha-mahave. Whereas the thing, the creative force that brings about the Metzias Gashmi into existence, she'ein b'vichinas Gashmi klal, that not b'vichinas Gashmi's. Ki im b'vichinas Madrega Ruchnis, it's a Madrega Ruchnis. And al shum zenikra ayin, that's why it's also called an ayin hepechayesh, the opposite of Gashmi's. Ayin means not Gashmi's, not a dover Gashmi. He makes a clear point. Omnam lo yitachin lo imar shenikra ayin. But we can exclude the possibility that it's not called ayin for this reason. Al shem shu ha'or ve'ena be'erech ha'etzim. It's not called ayin for the same reason why the ayin of the yesh of das elyon, the ayin of yesh lifnei ha'tzimtzum, is called ayin. The ayin of the das elyon is called ayin. Why? Because it's a ha'ara, and that makes it
bottle.
Not a Metzias Yesh, like the Yesh Amiti.
Right.
And it's bottle. Legabi Atzmus. It's Dovuk, it's bottle. And it's Eina Be'erech Ha'etzim. That does not apply to the Ayin of the Yesh Anivra. In Das Tachtim, when we say Ayin, we don't mean that. Ima Yoisha Emes Keinhu. Even though that's also true to an extent, it's a Ha'ara. And it's not Be'erech Ha'etzem. Right? It's true about the Ayin. What is it? It's a Ha'ara. It's an Oir. Oir HaKav is a Ha'ara.
Right.
And it's not Be'erech Ha'etzem. Right. But that's not why we're calling it Ayin over here. We're not making a statement about its relationship with its Mokir. Dimkein, Eich Yikro, HaNivro, Es Atzmo Yesh L'Gavim Mekir. Because in the context of Das Tachtung, if we're calling that Ayin, Ayin because it's ha'ara and it's ein be'erech etzem, how can we call ourselves a yesh? If my mocker is not a metzias, then how can I be a metzias?
So what?
My self-awareness would change my whole premise.
It's true.
It may be true, but that truth can come through his bonimus. That's not das tachtin.
Oh.
It's not the premise of das tachtin. Premise of Das Tachtin is there's a Yesh HaNivra and it has a Sheir Shemaka which we call Ayin. But we don't call it Ayin because of its bittul to its Maka and it being a horrible bad. Because if that would be the case, a person would make the conclusion, since my Maka is a Ha'ara and it's not Be'erech, Hare Nivra Raka Ara Da Ha'ara. Ayin Mashko Seisho Ben Echelik Beis Bergimu, O Yoyso Ein Arich. Which you're right, is a derech in hisbonimus. You're explaining about that, everything's just a horrible bad. So that means the head of tefis, a smakum of you, is bein arich to the head of tefis.
Right?
But that's already hisbonimus.
Isn't that hisbonimus of das tachtin?
No.
What?
That's a bit of das tachtin. Das tachtin is, the matter is a yesh, is a metzias.
Oh,
you can't retain.
It's like when we wake up in the morning, that's how we think.
Das tachtin.
Who?
Das tachtin. Is the observation that a Dover Gashmi is a Yesh.
Right.
And when we say Yesh, it's something which is Magish, it's Atzmusay, it's a Metzias. If you're going to come along and have a bunch of, and be misspaining about Bitala Ilamis, and that really there's nothing really a Metzias Yesh, and everything is Kol Beguf Kadr HaShemesh, that's what you're going to do, you're going to be Mavatal, everything fine, you'll be Mavatal Das Tachting.
And then there'll be no Yesh.
In Das Tachtin, in order to get a structure whereby you have a Yesh and then you have an Ayin, the Yesh cannot conceive of the Ayin as something which is completely bottled in Arich Gabi Makedo.
Right.
So the Ayin there does not mean that those terms, those things which we describe the Ayin of the Das Elyon of the Ayin of Shnei Atzimtzum cannot be applied to the Ayin of Das Tachtin. Yeah?
Right.
The Yadua Da Ayin Shall Yesha Amiti Va Ayin Shall Anish Nivra Ein Noibu Rechinas Ayin Echad. These two Ayins the ayin which we use in das elyon to refer to the inscription of the atzimtzum, and the ayin of das tachtin,
which refers to
the irakav, the ishlach atzimtzum, the irakav, the iratzilus.
Yeah, okay.
It's not the same ayin. Shenemar sheha ayin shleish amiti hu atzmai ha ayin hamahaves ayishnivra. We don't say that the ayin of the yesh amiti is the very same ayin which is going to go and create the yesh anivra. That is not the case. We do not say that. Sha'ayin shalo yesh amiti mi'achashu b'chinas ayin ve'efes ad she'ino ilu b'shem klal. This ayin of the yesh amiti, which is the ayin of sitch lifnei ha'tzimtzum, which he says are bilvad and is dovak m'mekeirei and is ayin is not it's ayin ilu b'shem klal me'mele ayin begedeli is mokit b'chinas mokit lahavis chuli. It can't create anything, as we said in the previous in the earlier paragraph, right? It can't. It's not shevish shemakel la'ilamis. The chol makel, the hechrich who eizem etzias dover mash and asem makel chuli. To be a makel is to be a something. It can't be a nothing. Nothing comes from nothing. Right? It has to be something. Va'ayin shel yesh amiti mi'achin megedem etzias. The whole notion of the ayin and the yesh amiti. Why is it called ayin? Because it's ein amitzias klal meila ein begedem makel gamkin. Can't be a makel of anything. So we're talking about two different ayins. It's important to distinguish between the two. But it's not. We're not going to look at this as a seidish daushlus. So you have yesh amiti, then you have the ayin of the yesh amiti, the ayin of the yesh amiti, and from the ayin of yesh amiti, there's nishava noch an ayin. The ayin shel yesh anivra, and then you have the creation of yesh anivra. So you have yesh, ayin, ayin, yesh. That's not what happens. Why? Why can you not have yesh, ayin, ayin, yesh? If you can't look at the whole seidish talshus, he's saying you might think if just said these two ayins are separate,
right?
So you might think, okay, so how do I look at seidish talshus? The yesh amiti, then you have the ayin shel yesh amiti. Yeah. Then you have the Tzimtzum, and then you have the Irakab, the Irin Sif Shla'achra Tzimtzum, which is the Ayin Shal Yesh HaNivra,
right.
And then you have the Yesh HaNivra.
Right.
So the structure of Vishtalshus for you would be Yesh, Ayin, Ayin, Yesh. But it's not to say that from the Ayin Harishin, which was the Ayin of the Yesh HaMiti, the Irin Sif Shla'achra Tzimtzum, Nimsa V'nishave HaAyin HaBeis. Why can't we say that? Ki Yadua, because it's known, this way you have this big long 621 footnote, which is leads you into the yeah. You can't have between every ayin, there has to be a yesh be'emtzah. And the same thing between every yesh. From one yesh to another yesh, you have to have an ayin be'emtzah. They don't.
So
they don't evolve, and from one ayin, you're not going to get evolved from it another ayin.
It's an ayin.
Precisely. Shemi ayesh, nasa ayin. Because it's from the yesh the ayin is produced.
So we've got five stuff now.
Because if
no.
So what? If you can't have yesh ayin yesh. And these two ions are two fundamentally different ions. Then what can you do? Say we blur the situation a bit. We say Ella, who masha ha ayin nechlok lishnayim. There's one ion, which is split in two. We've got. It's gonna go through it. Give it a chance. Ayin lebeis b'chinas hana. So from this one ion, it gets divided into these two categories of ion. The ayin of the yesh amiti and the ayin of the yesh anivra. Shechelak ha'elyon b'chinas ayin shel yesh amiti, v'chelak ha'tachtin b'chinas ayin shel yesh anivra.
Is this kasa?
No. I told you what it is. Ayin
right.
Shel yesh amiti, ayin shel yesh anivra. The ayin shel yesh amiti, the ayin shel yesh anivra. B'lich eira einim muvan. It's going to ask the obvious question here. How on earth does this work? Eich shayach bo ze inyin ha'ischalkus shenechlok lishnayim. Where Why? What is the fundamental problem with the situation? The mi'acha she'ena begedem mokim im nehedem etziyusay. If the fundamental of the ayin of the yeshan miti is why can it not be a mokir la'ilamayz? Because if it's not a metziyus bichla. Completely bottle. Ukum mo'ikei mitzad ma'alos ichuli kanam. And not just that, also mitzad is ma'ilam. The two things that we described in the paragraph on Samas. On Mitzamas. How from something which is completely, just like we said, it's impossible to have yesh ayin ayin yesh. For the same reason, you can't have yesh ayin split into two yesh. How does that ayin split in? Umihu machalka. Who splits them up? How is it bichlal that these two things can be within the same
category?
Yeah, of one ayin. And the whole thing is an interesting proposition that needs explaining, which he's going to do. He's going to explain, but and we're not going to go into that's going to be for the next year. But to just summarize, we're trying to figure out how the O is in Samson. What does it mean, Simsum Ha O? The tzimtzum in the O, which is the necessary condition for the Osius to become pronounced, and for the Osius to be able to be ma'ilam u'mastiv on the O and create the Yesh HaNivra. He said the whole purpose of creation, Hashem wanted to create the world, he wanted to create a Yesh HaNivra. And so initially he thought, I'll do this with Midas HaDin. And so we're trying to explain what that would look like. How it would look like to create the world Midas HaDin. And the Midas HaDin, how it's going to fit into the situation is that it's going to enable the Tzimtzum in the Ohr. It's going to enable the Tzimtzum in the Ohr such that there can therefore be the emergence of the Osius, the Bechinas Yesh. Okay, so we've got a lot going on. We're carrying a lot of material. We've got all the material from the Levar Ava. And now we are adding on these two Maimorim, as I said, are the most difficult, conceptually, difficult parts of the Hemshech. Because you've got to really hold a very broad argument with lots of Pratim and details together in one time. But that's why I think going through a bit quicker, we'll be able to get the skeleton of the idea. And then Be'ez Hashem, through learning more B'Shkid of Asmada, you'll be able to put flesh on those bones and make it substantive. Okay?
Okay.